everyday life is made complicated for a young nigga like me. Fucking round with the NOPD. See, I was running, dripping sweat, trying to catch the ferret. When a cop pulled his gun and said, nigga, don't you run. But I was in a rush, cause I'm trying to catch my buck. But then I stopped dead in my tracks and thought back the way they killed that young brother, Jerome Glover. And if the cops squeeze the trigger, I'm a dead ass. He thought I stole something, so he pulled like that Billy Club and hit me across my knee. Fucking with a nigga wanting to see some ID, and made the shit worse with an illegal search. They ran across checkers, they considered me a threat. But that's not the case, so the point I'm trying to make, they let my black ass go, but they kept my cash though. And wouldn't have thought twice about taking my life, cause I'm a motherfucking enemy to officer Brindley.
The fucking police pull you over, slam you down, and I ain't going for no shit like that.
Nigga, get your motherfucking food, leave it in the car, nigga, get out.
Officer the goddamn law.
Officer Friendly was friendly when he spoke at school, but in them black neighborhoods, he act a motherfucking fool. Rolling up, making niggas lay flat in the street, cause they think every nigga on the block is slinging rocks. So they gotta stop and harass me and try to chastise me with the questions they keep asking me. And figure they can rough me up, cause they got the ups with that badge and them cuffs. But I gotta be careful how I back him up off me. Oh, I might end up dead like Adolf Archie, or have my life shortened like that brother Corey Horton. So I'ma play it gently cause the odds are against me, and they don't give a fuck about me. Cause if I move too soon, I'm in the time picking you. Now read it in the headlines, black man found lynched, killed by cops in self-defense. So when they stop me, I'm wishing I don't come up missing. And you can tell they don't respect me by the way how they address me. Cause everything is nigga that or bitch this, and if I answer back, they beat me down with the quickness. And when they're done working up a sweat, they take me to jail for resisting arrest. But that there won't make new scene, and I won't have a case unless I get it on videotape. Cause that's the way the shit goes down when you're a motherfucking enemy to Officer Friendly.
Motherfucking police pull you over, slam you down, and I ain't going for no shit like that. Motherfucking police pull you over, slam you down, and I ain't going for no shit like that.
It's kinda close, but tell me whom should I fear the most? Them niggas on the streets or them police? But now I'm stuck, cause either way I turn to a fuck. Cause both of them hurt me until I beg for mercy. Cause they don't have no love for me, but the feeling is mutual, so they keep drawing blood from me. And it's not by free will, so they hunt me down like a deer and beat me to a standstill. Then frisk me, hoping to convict me and incarcerate me for them white folks' safety. Cause they claim them streets ain't safe, so they try to get rid of me and consider me a nigga. See, in a corporate, even if it ain't my phone shit. So when I see them coming, I'm taking off running, and I'ma dodge them cause they claiming I'm the problem. But the only solution is to keep on shooting until they take ya, so they can make the streets safer since I'm violent by nature. So they keep on watching me, filled with animosity. And if I don't cooperate, they're quick to put that Glock to me. So now I have a choice, either with Tulane and Braun or be sent to the morgue. But they do all they can to protect and serve the white man and try to keep me and my kind in line. With them years that they give them, rotting in that prism, making niggas worse than they was at first. Cause now they got that jailhouse mentality, and in Jefferson Parish, black folks get embarrassed. Cause in certain parts it don't pay to be dark, cause them white folks round that group for David Duke, and all strictly out to get me. Cause every mugshot posted of a convict fits me, and the path for me to take was already chosen, leading me straight to some jailhouse closed in. In a hellhole they built me, cause the black folks are guilty to prove them guilty. And that civil rights kick don't come for shit when you're a motherfucking enemy to Officer Friendly.
Motherfucking police pull you over, slam you down, and I ain't going for no shit like that. Motherfucking police pull you over, slam you down, and I ain't going for no shit like that.
Cops put a hurting on your ass, man. Cops put a hurting on your ass. Cops put a hurting on your ass, man. Cops put a hurting on your ass, man. Cops put a hurting on your ass, man. Cops put a hurting on your ass. Cops put a hurting on your ass, man. Cops put a hurting on your ass.
We'll be right back.
when the smoke went away, I heard him say, damn, they done killed Lil DeAndre. And he was only 18 years old when he caught it. So let me pay respect to the deal and depart it. Reminds me of something that the rebel used to say. How the good Lord give it, then he can't get the way. It used to be that people ain't die so soon, but now you're lucky if you stay alive to reach 25. But the killing didn't end that dope, cause another nigga had to go and kill Big Mo. But now I done got to where it's out of control. My man Pina got killed, long rest his soul. And it's not just like that where I come from, cause everywhere you look you hear niggas dying young.
Nigga dead.
Nigga know how to die. Been dying for 400 years.
Just another nigga dead.
Die, nigga. Nigga, die. Nigga,
watch another nigga
die. Niggas know how to die. Been dying for 400 years. Die, nigga. Nigga, die.
Sometimes at night I wake up wet, dripping in sweat, but I done dream that a nigga done laid me to rest. And the shit is so crazy cause I'm watching my step, but them young niggas these days looking for that rep of being that nigga who's quick to pull a trigger and I take a motherfucker out to try and get some house. So my mind get my own these days, cause brothers tend to front and I don't wanna get caught up on the other end, staring down a barrel cocked at point blank range. So I'm laying low cause bullets don't have no name. But if you're white, you ain't even gotta worry about that, cause 90% of it is black on black. But they the main motherfuckers that they did a nigga wrong. But if I even look at you, bitch, it's on. So when you gon' realize it's us that you're hurting over in the white neighborhood, they're living with the curtains. But niggas know better than to fuck with them. But you watch me bleed, even though we from the same seat. So where I'm at, I gotta watch my back and get dead boat locks just to keep what I got. And watch what I'm wearing before my life gets taken from this world and this motherfucking crisis. So let me watch the news and find out the scope of all the young niggas that got took to the float. And when the year's over, they add it up and give you a sum of all the niggas that
just
died
nigga
young.
Dead.
Everywhere you go, everywhere you go, niggas dying.
Nigga dead.
Niggas been dying for 400 years.
Now let's see if David Duke would pass a bill to do something about these young niggas getting killed. And them other politicians who act like they care, but get that is to pull a switch when the niggas in the chair. See, before they save black males, they'd rather save the wealth and tend to the needs of the people overseas. And try to make it seem like everything is fine while we falling like lumber and dying by the number. Cause we all know the male is the root of a race. As he drop his seed and watch it grow into an embryo, but dying too soon without planting in the womb a seed to produce. And that's black youth to bring up an offspring for future generations. And niggas keep dying young all across the nation. And them white folks know a race of people is like a tree, cut it off at the root and you can't produce. So they steady trying to hold me back like a levy, pushing guns in my neighborhood and still the libraries. Now more and more niggas keep dying, but every time the trigger snaps, we killing our own kind. But if them same niggas jumped up and started capping white folks, watch out, quick shit'll happen. Then you'll see push coming, push for aid. If they started sending young white niggas to the grave, but until then they play the sideline without getting the damn thing done. Cause just niggas dying young.
So dead nigga undertakers get rich burying dying niggas.
Nigga.
Die nigga. Niggas always trying to die. Niggas get shot. Die nigga.
Nigga.
Niggas
dead.
Get hung. Die nigga.
Yeah man, niggas need to quit that shit cause there's too
you
many
ass.
Niggas dying young. But yo, look, let me throw this little shout out, give respect to the dealer deported. I like throwing a shout out to DeAndre Green, my man around the corner, better known as Peanut, long rest his soul.
Mojo Black, you can't forget about Quack, man.
Alright, my man Kyle Young, I can't never forget about him.
And Big too, man.
And Andre Brooks.
Jamal Joseph.
Jared Harrison, better known as Big Mo.
Corey Hart,
Beast D. Bill, man.
Add all parts, Anthony Fuller from out of street
stand
book.
Over them and laugh.
Lord, rest
niggas watch
soul.
Some redneck
rest
punks
in peace, brother.
Stand over them and laugh. Niggas watch some redneck hunky stand over them and laugh. Niggas watch some redneck hunky stand over them and laugh. Niggas watch some redneck hunky stand over them and laugh. Niggas watch some redneck hunky stand over them and laugh. Niggas watch some